truly Tualatin is the best city in America.
Meridian Park is proud of the role we have played in driving economic vitality in Tualatin, being the anchor of its healthcare sector.
And we applaud Tualatin for its innovation in getting more STEM and CTE opportunities into their schools.
And now for the man of the hour. Our next speaker really needs no introduction, as many of you probably know him personally. Mayor Lou Ogden is one of the longest serving mayors in the state of Oregon, having served in Tualatin since 1994. In his 20 plus years of service to the Tualatin community, he's overseen the acquisition of hundreds of acres of lands for parks, greenways, and natural areas, and has supported economic development efforts, resulting in assessed value growth from $900 million to $4 billion today. He has served as the president of the League of Oregon Cities, the president of the Western Municipal Association. He's been on the National League of Cities Board of Directors and various local and regional boards and steering committees. He's been the recipient of many awards honoring his commitment to public service in the region, including the Tualatin Distinguished Service and Citizen Award, the Oregon Mayors Association Leadership Award, the League of Oregon Cities James C. Richards Memorial Award. These groups know Lou Ogden as a leader. The residents of Tualatin know him as mayor. Those of us here gathered here tonight know him as our friend. Would you join me, please, in welcoming the mayor of America's best community, Lou Ogden.
Thank you very much. Hello, Tualatin. Is that too loud? Well, thanks for the kind introduction. And if you look at your program, that's not Joe. Joe V was our MC tonight, called in ill, and at the last hour, Jonathan Schleter, friend of mine from years back, stepped up and did a great job. So thank you. But I would just correct most of everything that he and Jim and others said. This is not about me. It's not about me. It's not even about necessarily 12th City Council. It's about everyone here in this room and everybody in this community. We're all in this parade together. I just have the privilege and honor, perhaps, of riding in the front horse of the parade. But this is all about you. You are the best. This is the best night of the year for me, because I get to recognize all of you and the great work that the best people in our community do this past year and what we're doing in the future. Did I mention that we're the best? Have you heard that yet tonight? Well, there's the theme here, in case you hadn't caught on yet. Tualatin, and there's two words, partnering to be the best. Our quest to be the best, as you've already heard, began in this recent expose in last year, as the city, the chamber, the Mask of Mirrors Community Theater, Tiger Tualatin School District, South Metro Salem STEM, all together came as a partnership, and many local businesses, to develop a concept to increase opportunities for all our youth. There's one right there. And to increase STEM education opportunities as pathways for our high school students into manufacturing and technology jobs right here in Tualatin. So as you heard, STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math, as Jim pointed out, we brought in the A, the arts, to make it STEAM. The plan was submitted for the America's Best Communities competition, sponsored nationwide by Frontier Communications, and Tualatin, as you heard, was selected as one of 50 cities in the United States to receive a $50,000 award to develop a community revitalization plan. And the key revitalization here is education opportunities for all of our students at all levels. So our community stepped up and raised an additional $28,000 to advance these efforts, and that was part of our local match. And get this, more than 30 people and businesses contributed that $28,000. And we had Lamb Research, who gave a huge contribution, and we have individuals who gave small contributions, and even the Methodist Church even took up a collection. So Pastor, you're right, God is on our side. And as you've heard, just last month, we heard that we were then selected as one of 15 of the 50 to compete for 8 second-round prizes of $100,000. So we'll be traveling to Durham, North Carolina, next month or in April, and we'll show the panel of judges that we truly are the best community in America. So I'd like to recognize our ABC team members, John Bartholomew and Gary Romans from Mask and Mirror Community. All right, so I can't see out there, but you can. So I'm going to have you stand up here in a minute. But I got, I mentioned Gary and John from Mask and Mirrors, Linda Moholt from the Tualatin Chamber, Tualatin City Councilor Frank Bubinick, Tualatin Tomorrow Committee's Candace Kelly, Larry McClure, Ed Casey, and then Noel Gorbett and Jill Hubbard from Tiger Tualatin School District, Charlie Hopewell from Sunset Manufacturing, and Linda Hansen from World of Speed. That was the group that put this together. So thanks to those folks and the work they've done to bring so many of our partners into this community to come up with this award-winning idea to benefit our youth, our community, and help prepare them to fill the technical jobs offered by our manufacturing companies right here in Tualatin. And of course, we can't thank enough Frontier Communications and Renee and the gang for actually making this whole award possible. So this is just kind of one example of how our community comes together and partners to make Tualatin absolutely the best we truly can be. Because why? Because people care. People care about their kids, they care about their community, they care about their neighborhoods, they care about their jobs, they care about their businesses, they care about the overall livability of this community. And that's the honor and privilege that we have as a city council to take that responsibility seriously, to make Tualatin the best it can be. So what I'd like to do now is I want to share a brief video that highlights this and some other examples about how Tualatin is the best community. I've always known that Tualatin is America's best community. And in 2015, leaders from our community submitted an application for Frontier's America's Best Communities competition, where we competed with nearly 400 cities from across this nation. And Tualatin was selected as one of 50 quarterfinalists. And then just this January, we were selected as one of 15 semifinalists. Tualatin is the best because of the people who live here, those who work here, and because of the many partners who come together to collaborate on achieving a shared community vision. I'm proud to call Tualatin home for so many reasons, from our great parks and neighborhoods to the best business community and our volunteers. This community truly is the best.
In order to talk about the Tualatin River Greenway Trail, we need to step back in history just a little bit. This area is just phenomenal. We have beautiful trees, amazing rivers, and it's just a magnificent place to run, walk, experience. This area was once traversed by giant mastodons, giant sloths. Early hunter-gatherers walked these lands, and today we get to walk in their footsteps, so it's just an amazing place to be. You know, really this is about connectivity, and we're combining or conjoining trails together to create a larger system of trails. It's beautiful. So when business and community partner together, amazing things can happen, as is evidenced here.
Tualatin's public art is terrific because it celebrates Tualatin yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Tualatin has a very unique program called Visual Chronicle for students. The City of Tualatin, the Tualatin Arts Advisory Committee, teams up with Tiger Tualatin School District and Janine Miller to create art in the high school, where students will create pieces of art during the school year, and at the end of the school year, there's a show here in town, and that the city will end up purchasing 1, 2, 3, maybe 4 pieces of art for display. The Student Visual Chronicle is a great way to get students involved and youth involved in the arts. The Tualatin Arts Advisory Committee encourages businesses in the community to have art here in town. For example, McDonald's has done the salmon fountain, which everybody really likes a lot. We have the Meridian Park Hospital has created the healing gardens as a piece of art. You also have Nyberg Rivers that did the mastodon as art here in town. The Chamber of Commerce is encouraging businesses to show and display art in their businesses because, one, art is business, and also exposes artists here in the community to see pieces of art, and they have a wandering art exhibit right now going from business to business in town.
Tualatin employees are the best for a variety of reasons. One big reason is because they care. They care about the work that they do. They care about the services they provide. We've been able to recruit and retain really high quality employees that are technically very competent and passionate about the work that they do. And they feel really supported by the community and by the council. City of Tualatin employees are the best.
Tualatin has the best schools, teachers, and students because it's all about people. And the people that we have in the school district are just amazing. The dedication of our teachers and the willingness of our teachers to just step in and do whatever it takes to provide a great experience for our kids is inspiring each and every day, the stories that I hear coming out of our schools. From a community standpoint, we have community members that, again, that are willing to step in at a moment's notice and help us in any number of ways. Sometimes that's big, like in supporting funding measures, like a local option or a bond. But the volunteerism that happens in our schools each and every day really makes a difference for kids. And I think that's what sets Tualatin apart from so many other communities.
Tualatin has the best library because it provides more resources to people and it helps our community. We have all sorts of events, which provides for kids to adults to teens. We have Dia de los Muertos, movie nights on Fridays, Dr. Seuss parties, Hunger Games, and Divergent parties. It's important for teens to be involved because it provides them new open doors, meet new people, new resources for them to bring into the future. It builds out their resume and builds for leadership skills. It provides over the summer, there's a summer teen program for them to volunteer at the library. There's also a teen library committee, which I'm part of, and there's a lot of ways that teens can get involved.
I think actually Tualatin's really unique in that I think it resides kind of on the periphery of the central urban area of Portland. But this area has an amazing amount of diversity in regard to the products and services that are actually manufactured and distributed from this area. I think it's a unique community from that standpoint. Well, because of the diversity, because of the people, because of the businesses, and because of the people, Tualatin is America's best community.
The best thing about Tualatin is the people who live here and those who work here. Thank you for all you do to make Tualatin America's best community.
Because we are the best.
Because we're the best.
We are the best.
We're the best.
Because 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 we're the best.
We're the best.
Well, that's the beginning of the tribute. You know, as in previous years, I get a chance, as I said, to recognize a lot of people. I'm going to do that tonight. So when I say your name, I'd like you to stand up. Now, there's going to be a lot of up and down tonight, so nobody's going to go to sleep. Hopefully, nobody's going to get tired of getting up and down. But not only do I want to thank these folks, but I want you to help me thank them. So when you came in tonight, or at your chair, I guess, you got a rally towel, right? You got a towel that says that Tualatin is America's best community. So when I say you're the best to whomever we're referring to, I want you to wave your flag and go, we're the best. Are you with it? You got your flag? You got your towel? All right, so let's practice on the ABC folks here for a moment. All the folks that I mentioned, they're part of that ABC team. And if you would stand up, and all the companies who contribute to the ABC, if you're here, stand up. Stand up, everybody stand up. And you're the best. You're the best. All right. You guys catch on pretty quick. So let me thank you just again to some of the people that made this event happen tonight. You've heard from some of them already, but our supporting sponsors are Northwest Natural, Clean Water Services, and TriMet. Our presenting sponsor, Frontier Communications and Comcast. Our title sponsors were Republic Services and PGE. And oh my gosh, Perlow Construction stepped up, not only at the platinum level and put several thousand dollars and paid for the food that you had tonight, but as Chris said, built this building. Special thanks to Jack Martin, who owns this building and graciously let us use it, and to, again, all of our sponsors that are on the long list. If you'd all stand up, if you all the sponsors would stand up, you're the best. Yeah, you're the best, all right. You got it, you guys are good. I hope you all had a chance to visit the business showcase that was put on back there this evening and check out Tualatin's industrial community. You know, I wanted to connect our residents who live here and our students who are educated here with the manufacturing community and the jobs that are available and the products and services that they produce that are sold and used around the world and around the corner. So, you know, it was a great turnout tonight. Thanks to all the folks that participated. Tualatin typically has the lowest unemployment in the state of Oregon. And that's typical, and that's because of this tremendous job base. They're the backbone of our local economy. And get this, the business community, the industrial and the commercial community together pay about half of the property taxes that provide your city services, your parks, police, and library. So a big thanks to our sponsors of the showcase, Legacy Meridian Park, Lamb Research, Pacific Foods, McLean Food Services, E-Road, Thermal Modification Technology, Sunset Manufacturing, Space Saver Specialists, Albina Company, DPI Specialty Northwest, California Closets, Redaway Trucking, Western Precision, CEC, Columbia Corrugated Box, Helzer Industry, you're the best! Yeah! Oh, I like it. The Tualatin Chamber of Commerce organized this showcase tonight. You know, they really do carry out their mission of business and community working together. Linda Moholt, she's our Tualatin Energizer buddy, throwing herself headlong. Yeah, headlong into anything and everything that's Tualatin. Linda's there. And Liz Hatcher, oh my gosh, Liz, thank you for helping coordinate this on such short notice. You did an amazing job. All right, so could the chamber staff, the business owners, the showcase sponsors, and the chamber board, you guys all stand up and take a bow. You're the best. Yeah. Okay, hey, how about the jazz band when you came in tonight? The Tualatin High School Jazz Ensemble led by Reggie Stegmeyer. Is the band member still here? Are them still here? Are they? All right, yeah, you're the best. And how about the Crimson Airs with that beautiful rendition of our national anthem? Kim Krager brings that in every year. And also I want to mention, a lot of the Crimson Airs are in Tualatin High School's production of South Pacific, and that starts this weekend. So Tualatin's finest on the stage at the auditorium. Get your tickets now. Another thanks to Dale Potts and Joel, who did the Pledge of Allegiance and represent our veterans. And they do so much to help us remember how important it is to recognize our veterans and their families. And they actually are instrumental in Tualatin becoming a Purple Heart City, which we instituted this year to recognize those who are injured and even killed, protecting our freedoms. So Dale and Joel, if you guys are here, stand up, take a bow. Joel's in the back, Dale's up front, you're the best. How about the color guard? So we had the Tualatin Valley Fire Rescue. I got Tiger Tualatin School District, we had too many T's. We just call it the Tualatin School District, make it simple. Yeah, Tualatin Fire Department, Tualatin Police Department shared the color guard honors tonight. And I wanna thank from the police department, Wes Girardi and Jack Rose, Eric Herman, Matt Messina, and from TVFNR, Steve Mills, Dean Schultz, John Wolf, Scott Bronner, and my good friend with the bagpipes, I don't see him out there, but Tim Burr, thank you for doing this. Very special, Tim, thank you. You guys, you're the best. Yeah. Pastor Juarez, I'm so proud to have Esperanza in Tualatin as part of Tualatin Horizon Community Church. Thank you for the work you do in the community. Thank you for celebrating with us this evening and for the work you do. And I can't see you through these lights, but there he is. The work you do to support our Spanish-speaking folks and engaging them and helping them serve in our community. And we try to do the same thing back at City Hall, supporting our Hispanic citizens with English language learning classes and bilingual programs and bilingual collections in our library materials, cultural celebration. Eric, you're the best. I'm really pleased that a lot of my friends, elected officials, are here tonight. It says a lot to know that we do partner together. I would like to ask all the elected officials in the crowd to stand up, and I'm going to introduce you one by one so I can see if you'd all stand up. These folks spend countless hours. That would be stand-up time. These folks do countless. Yeah, okay. Well, pre-up, you're the best. But stay standing. Stay standing for a minute. Tualatin may have a river. We may have a lake, but we're not an island. We can't get anything done by ourselves. All the prosperity that we enjoy that comes from public finance and all those capabilities only happen because we work together. So special thanks to, and I've got Tualatin City Council I'm going to recognize first. I got Ed Truax And I saw Joel Davis. Where's Joel? Frank is here. Frank, I didn't see is Wade, but there's Wade, Nancy Grimes. And so these guys, along with the mayors, I call her KC, Chris Anna Clark, my mayor neighbor from Sherwood, Mayor John Cook from Tigard, Washington County Chair Andy Dyke. Washington County is the best partner that Tualatin has ever had. My good friend Pete Truax, the mayor of Forest Grove, I'll never forget the first day in the city I did. The first one he was elected, all the way from Forest Grove. I didn't know the map even unfolded that far. And he came all the way over to Tualatin to fight their traffic and beer. I appreciate that. Next door neighbor, Gary Serrato from Durham. My big brother mayor, Hillsborough, Jerry Willie. Hillsborough is the biggest city in Washington County. They're really a shining light for the rest of us. Gordon Hoveys, Tualatin Valley Fire and Rescue Board of Directors. And I can't see way in the back. Oh, Jill, is that Jill? Right, Jill Zirkmead, Tualatin Tigard School Board. Thank you, Jill. And if I get everything on this side, and in the back, I got Craig Dirksen, who's our Metro Counselor. And Metro has been a huge partner, that I'll talk about more later. And Russ Axelrod, yeah, there's a towel for Russ, the mayor of West Lynn, our neighbor to the east. And Tim Knapp, our neighbor to the south, mayor of Wilsonville. And Frank Bubnick, who I've already mentioned, but Tualatin City Council. And did I miss anybody? Who's that in the back? John Goodhouse, Tigard City Council, Tualatin Chamber Board of Directors. Thanks for being here. Big round of applause for these folks. You know, the mayors, we meet once a month. In fact, we met just today at lunch here in Tualatin. Typically, 20 or more mayors get together to share issues of concern, how we can support each other, how we can work together, and sometimes how we have differences and how we can honor those differences and still be supportive. I want to give a particular thank you to one mayor. They're all great. They're all friends of mine, and we work together so closely. But I want to just say a word about Mayor Tim Knapp from Wilsonville. From the day Tim took office about 6 years ago, he and I have worked closely together on some really very challenging issues. And together, we formed new alliances between Tigard and Tualatin, between Tualatin and Wilsonville. I should read my notes. Between Tualatin and Wilsonville that absolutely would not have been formed without Tim Knapp being in the mayor's chair and his commitment to those partnerships. You know, they say you can choose your friends, but you can't choose your neighbors, okay? Well, Tim Knapp in Wilsonville is my friend and our neighbor, so thanks, Tim, for being so supportive. Yeah. I saw Commissioner Roy Rogers from Washington County earlier and Commissioner Paul Savas. I think they had gone to another meeting tonight, but thank you all. So, did we say John? I said John. John Cook, Tigard? Yeah. John and I, we share the bridge of the gods between Tigard and Tualatin, as Pastor Warris would say. So, hey, look, ladies and gentlemen, the state of the city in Tualatin is the best. It's never been so good. This past year, we welcomed 160 new businesses. We added nearly 700 new jobs. We broke ground on major connection of the Tualatin River Greenway Trail. We tackled challenges on issues of importance such as transportation, our city facilities needs, preparing our youth for the skills and knowledge they need to be prepared. The progress that this community has made year after year is remarkable, and it's only possible, why? Because of the partnerships of the folks who come together, the partnerships that do make Tualatin the best. So, in 2015, we made major progress on transportation partners. So we well know transportation is a top priority in this community. If you had an encounter getting here today on Tualatin Sherwood Road, it's basically on everybody's mind. For years, we've advocated for increased transit service and funding for major arterials, and have been studying bringing high-capacity transit to the southwest part of the region. So I'm pleased to announce these efforts are actually paying off. Last year, I want to start with some big news. TriMet announced that Tualatin will get a new bus line. Bus line 97 coming to Tualatin from Sherwood, servicing this industrial area, servicing along Tualatin Sherwood Road with connections to the MASC, to the West Station, and on into downtown Tualatin. And it will operate during the commute hours. A huge win for Tualatin. years of doing that. That's a big congratulations to Tualatin and Sherwood, and thanks to TriMet. But TriMet also expanded to Tualatin shuttle service. They hired Ride Connection. The Chamber did it for years and years and years. TriMet contracted the Ride Connection. They expanded the service. We have two lines now running during the shuttle of the peak commute hours. And then they got an award or a grant this year to expand the shuttle so that it now provides senior and disabled services during the day. And by the way, Ride Connection is currently looking for volunteer drivers to expand that daytime service for seniors and disabled. So if you want to drive a bus, let us know. I want to also congratulate our aging task force and Susan Nowak and that team, because they've been instrumental in helping get that new service. We also have been studying how we can better serve this part of the region with high capacity transit. So the Southwest Corridor Project is underway. It's been underway for a while, but in the past year, the steering committee has been refining the alignment to what will either be perhaps light rail or bus rapid transit connecting the Southwest suburban area to downtown Portland. So we determined that it's not feasible to bring high capacity transit to downtown Tualatin. There isn't the financing to do that. But the terminus of the line is still being considered, does it in Tualatin at Bridgeport Village. But I want to point out that a big part of the high capacity Southwest Corridor study is not just either light rail or bus rapid transit, but it's expanded local bus service connecting the high capacity transit to neighborhoods and jobs and businesses. And it also includes expansion of our major arterials and improvements on I-5 and 205. It's not just about light rail. It's about expanding transportation in the corridor. And speaking of that, we broke ground this year on the biggest transportation improvement to Tualatin in decades. This past November, our partners, including Washington County, Wilsonville, Sherwood, Willamette Water Supply, we broke ground on a $30 million roadway improvement of 124th Avenue extension. Construction will begin this spring. We'll be driving on it in the fall of 2018. 124th extension will connect south from Tualatin Sherwood Road down to Tonkin Road. And then a new road, Basalt Creek Parkway, will extend initially to Graham's Ferry Road with improvements to get to I-5 at the North Wilsonville exit. This project is so important because it not only serves as a major transportation link to our neighbors to the south, but it serves our industrial area, provides access to all the future development between Tualatin and Wilsonville, and improved traffic, hopefully, on Tualatin Sherwood Road. These major improvements to advance our community vision and mobility would not be possible, again, without all the partners that I mentioned, their staffs, their elected leadership, all the folks committed to keep those projects going. So thank you to TriMet, to Ride Connection, to Metro, to Washington County, Wilsonville, Sherwood, Willamette Water, our legislators, our county commissioners, the Tualatin Chamber, our city council, the citizens, the businesses, and all of those who've been advocating for transportation improvements in Tualatin over the years. You're the best. Everybody stand up in that group and take a big bow. We're so excited about where that's going. So while we've made progress this year in moving people around, we're also making great strides, if you don't pardon the pun, to move people around Tualatin on foot and on bicycles. And you saw the video glimpse of the new connection of the Tualatin River Greenway behind Nyberg Rivers and Cabela's, underneath I-5, connecting behind Nyberg Woods. We got a short detour around RV Park in Portland until that gets built out, hopefully in the near future. And it provides that critical link. As Chad said, it's not only a connection for transportation, but it's beautiful. It connects people to nature. It'll enable cyclists and walkers, and it will be a connection between residents and the commercial shopping areas. Again, all those partners, and I'll add to the list this time, the state of Oregon, Washington County, I said CenterCal, Metro, even the Oregon Public Health Institute, who helped us raise $3 million for that project. Again, partnerships. Tualatin's parks and the Juanita Pole Center for our population of 55 and better, of which I'm proudly a part of these days. And the Tualatin Library, you guys are the best. They offer gathering spaces for the community where people can connect, where people can learn, where they can stay healthy, they can have fun. And our community services department, led by Paul Hinn and his crew, and Paul, I know you're out there, Rich, they do an awesome job of making sure people of all ages and all interests have places together, fun, exciting things to do. Let me give you some examples of what we achieved this year. This summer, a Parks for Youth camp grew 30% in participants. Our teens completely filled out our adventure camp programs. The Juanita Pool Center, get this, had 37,000 participants in their programs and nearly 63,000 people walking through the door of the Pool Center last year. Again, a big thanks to the Pool Center Advisory Committee and the Tualatin Aging Task Force. This very energetic group meets monthly, sometimes more, with their mission to ensure the highest quality of life for the diverse, active, over age 50 population in the Tualatin area. Last year, the city, along with its other partners, brought you events such as what? The West Coast Pumpkin Brigada, the concerts on the Commons, movies on the Commons, starry nights and holiday lights, Art Splash, and who can forget the annual Tualatin Crawfish Festival. Now, the festival turned age 65 last year, so I guess they get to participate in that over age group as well. But you know what? They're still active and vibrant. Our biggest year, we drew 17,000 people. It expanded to 3 days, thanks to our partner, Mike Higgins at Social Media Northwest, who made that happen, the Tualatin Chamber, who staged that event for 25 years, a longtime partner of the event. And this year, a special thanks to a new partner to the festival, the Hood to Coast Race Series, took over the crawfish crawl, expanding it to include a 10K and a half marathon. And what was really cool about that is that they had nearly 1,500 people, including the runners and families, at the festival before the festival even opened to jumpstart it and kick it off. So thanks to all of those that I mentioned, Mike and the Chamber and Jude Hubber. If you guys are here, Mike Higgins, stand up. You guys really are the best. I appreciate all you do. Tualatin's library is also Tualatin's living room. It's a central gathering place. You go there, you got a cozy fireplace. People can hang out, kids hang out, teens hang out, adults hang out, come to learn, create, and play. And this year, we actually expanded the parking lot. How cool is that? And we put in the drive-through book drop, which people have been crying for. Also, but you maybe not thought about that this was the hottest summer on record. So the Tualatin Library became a cool refuge for people to get out of the heat who otherwise were in the sweltering temperatures. We extended the weekend hours 5 times throughout the summer to provide that escape. In keeping with Tualatin being the best, we know our library is the best. For the 5th consecutive year, we had the highest level of adult participation in our summer reading program of anywhere in the county. 2.9 million minutes read as part of our community reading challenge. Over 3,000 books given away to kids and teens. And summer reading participants were over 2,000. So we know we have the best librarians, too. How do I know that? Is Amy Michael here? Amy, are you here? Amy was selected by the 2015 Oregon Young Adult Network Your Excellent Award. That's the Oregon Library Association's Teen Librarian of the Year Award. So we're lucky to have Amy right here in Tualatin. Amy, you've proven that you're the best. So a little bit about the activity in the Tualatin Library. Can you believe 300,000 people visit our library every year? That's more than the entire population of our city every month. Our programs have increased by more than 50%. We've got the Tualatin Library Foundation, who are huge contributors. We've got the Friends of the Library, who donated more than $22,000 support programs this year. And the people of Tualatin stepped up, and as voters not only approved the operating levy, but we approved at a higher level in Tualatin than the overall approval percentage of the county, proving that in Tualatin, we really do love our libraries, as well as we love our parks. And I want to give thanks to all the staff and then the committees, the Parks Committee, the Poll Advisory Committee, the Aging Task Force, Library Committee, the Library Foundation, Friends of the Library. You guys are here. Stand up. You're the best. You're the best, all of you, for the library. We talked about education. You know, that's not the role of the city council or the mayor or the city staff, but we have wonderful schools that we partner with, and I'm continuing to be impressed by their commitment to ensuring that our community receives the best education, preparing our kids for the future. Tualatin's competition for America's Best Community only worked because of the partnership we had with the school district and bringing that STEM education program to roll it out into the workplace. So Superintendent Ernie Brown and Jill Hubbard, Noel Gorbett, Melissa DuBois, if you're here, I want to thank you folks from the district to the work you did to not only improve our ABC chances, but to extend career technical education. There was a $385,000 grant that they successfully competed for and won to roll out more technical education for our kids, to partner with people like the World of Speed, thank you, Lynette Hansen, and other companies that will soon be taking kids out of training programs, putting them in the workplace. Those pathways will help students develop the skills they need to provide family-way jobs for their families, regardless of what their education level is. PhD, master's, four-year, two-year, or the trades, and that's what we need to raise the tide and lift the boats for all of our young people. I really appreciate what you guys are doing. And it isn't just the district. You know, Pastor Juarez from Horizon Community School, they have a high school here. We have Mitch Charter School. And then, of course, folks in the east side of Tualatin are part of Westland-Wilsonville District. We even have some Lake Oswego kids in Tualatin. Speaking of kids, one of my favorite things about being mayor is you get to work with our youth council. We have the Youth Advisory Council, which, as mentioned, gets to go to Washington, D.C. every year because of the sponsorship of our shared utilities here. We have the Teen Library Committee. We have Team Tualatin. We have the Summer Grade Program. We have the CE2 kids. We have the Stand Up Tualatin. The Stand Up Tualatin kids here, these are kids who've taken a vow to oppose drug and alcohol abuse. Thank you, Stand Up Tualatin kids. Did I mention the national, FBLA, Future Business Leaders of America? Get this. Our FBLA class has won the state championship 5 years in a row. This year will be number 6. 10 out of the last 14. You talk about a dynasty, that's no accident. So all of our youth, stand up. I appreciate what you guys do. This is our future. This is what this is all about. This is why we are here. We're here for you. And I'm so proud of what you accomplished. You know, I want to recognize another group at Tualatin High of young people. It's called Intercambio. This is a group of students, they're high school students, and they mentor middle school students. And you know what? The graduation rate of those kids that are being mentored is nearly 100%. So just an amazing thing, Mr. Willen, who puts that together. We had the If I Were a Mayor contest winner statewide this year was Emma Patton. I think I saw Emma here earlier. If you're here, wave your hand, Emma. Just great things that our kids are doing. We have our library teen mentors were focused in the newspaper, Kevin Fessler, Donald Swigert, Beth Clark. Again, thanks to all the youth, and thanks to all the people who support you. You're the best. All right, talking about youth, I got three more things on youth. I want to mention two entities in this community that do so much for youth. A lot of people do a lot of things for youth. But two entities, one is the Tualatin Chamber of Commerce, another is the Tualatin Rotary. And together, those two groups fundraise through their events and make substantial, they contribute thousands of dollars every year in scholarships to Tualatin High School and Horizon's kids, most of which are kids that this is the first time in the family someone will be going to college. So Linda Wohold, our Tualatin Chamber CEO, if you're here, stand up. Jeff Smith, past president of Tualatin Rotary, are you here? Stand up, Jeff, Linda, you guys are the best. All right, there's a lady, I hope she's here. I didn't see her earlier. I want to pay special tribute to Leah Fittner. Leah, are you here? Leah, stand up. Now, don't clap yet. Let me talk. You just keep standing. You can't sit down. This is amazing. This lady stepped up for small kids in a very big way. She decided that the youngsters in Tualatin need a community track to instill a sense of active living with access for a host of young kids from a variety of neighborhoods of all kinds of demographics and backgrounds. So she and her neighbors put their shoulders to the grindstone, and they're in the process of completing nearly $100,000 of fundraising effort to build what I call a peewee track for peewees in our community. And it's gonna be on the grounds approved by the school district at Bridgeport Elementary. You got an artist rendering of it there. Leah leveraged a variety of very significant grants, and this is really a finesse job. They were layered one on the other, all sort of dependent upon the other to get to that $100,000. But the linchpin, the one piece that made it happen, it would not happen were it not for this, was the $25,000 grant recently approved by the Tualatin Rotary Club. So again, Tualatin Rotary, Leah, you guys are the best. go back to our businesses just for a minute. You know, I mentioned about the assessed value. I'm going to say that again. More than half the property taxes collected by the city of Tualatin are paid by the business community. That means the folks that live here that access our parks, our libraries, our police, they get it for half price because the business community is paying the other half. And that development work occurs because of our partners, Tualatin Chamber, Westside Economic Alliance, Greater Portland Inc., Business Oregon, WorkSource Oregon. They were all here tonight. Thank you for all you do to advance our community and our region. As I said, we added nearly 700 new jobs. We're on the move again in 2016. New businesses like Industry Cafe, who provided your food tonight that Perlow paid for. Thank you very much. Cracker Barrel, the first one in Oregon, is going to Nyberg Rivers. This building, the Southwind Industrial Park, the Coach Corporate Center, Meridian Business Park, others will soon be filled with new tenants as this year rolls out. We hope, Chris, right? We value the business community, rely on what you do. You guys really are the best. And they also, as I mentioned, contributed the local match on the ABC grant. ABC asked us to get into round two to demonstrate local commitment by raising $15,000. We blew the doors off. We raised $28,000. And I'm going to tell you who they were. Not all of them, the list goes on, but these are the businesses here in the room that contributed. Sunset Manufacturing, Lamb Research, World of Speed, Robert Knight from Express Employment Professionals, Cheryl Dorman and Company from Columbia Bank, Fred Bruning, Chad Hastings from CenterCal, J.K. Husha, Refco, Doug Klein from Klein's Orthodontics and a primary rotary pillar in our community, Max Helzer from Helzer Industries, Dave Simmons from CH2M Hill, John Reeson from Ujimi, Dave and Janet Dalton's Catering, Frank Lundgren and the whole gang at Republic, Bob Durgan, Anderson Construction, Renee Willer again from Frontier, who made all that happen. Thank you, guys. You're the best. Thank you. We wouldn't be able to do it without you. We're talking a minute about our volunteers. Do you know we had over 2,000 people knock on the door of the city of Tualatin and say, I want to volunteer for something in the city? That is not counting all the volunteers in the churches and in service clubs and athletics. That's 2,000 people knocked on the door and said, we want to volunteer at the city of Tualatin for more than 26,000 hours, planting trees, shelving books, helping kids, adults, corporate groups that volunteer, companies that volunteer. And we recognize some of these special volunteers. They're all special. But we had outstanding adult volunteers. Sunya Ambule and Beth Clark, I don't know if you're here. If you are, please stand up. Our outstanding elder volunteers from the Over 50 and Active and Better group, Jane Heathman and Don Swigert, and our outstanding youth group, Tualatin, Team Tualatin. Thank you to our outstanding volunteers. You guys are the best. All right. Advisory committees. Nothing happens at the city council. I guess I should finish that sentence. Nothing happens at the city council without the work of the advisory committees. The Arts Committee, the Architecture Review, Parks Committee, Tualatin Tomorrow, Library Committee, Courtyard Parking, Budget Committee. All of these boards are staffed by almost 100 people who give three-year sentences to these committees and come monthly and even more often. Tualatin Division, Tualatin Tomorrow Vision is almost 80% implemented because of the time and effort of our community partners as part of that. And that list goes on and on, but they're most of the usual suspects I've already mentioned, plus the Historical Society, our CIOs, Tualatin Together, and all of the others I mentioned previously. Thank you for your support to make Tualatin the best. There's a very special volunteer I want to recognize. I didn't see him tonight. I hope he's here. Is Chad Darby here? Chad, stand up. So Chad had the vision of Tualatin neighbors growing surplus garden produce and then donating it to those who have need. What an idea. So working together with Councilor Frank Bubinick and others, they turned that vision into neighbors nourishing community. So with donations of seed and tools and starts from vendors including Victory and Territorial Seed Company, more than two dozen families and three community gardeners produced more than a ton of fresh produce and took it down to the Tualatin Schoolhouse Pantry. And in addition to that, more than a dozen low-income families were able to start their own gardens. And speaking of youth, what else they did? Oh, wait a minute, there's more. Don't touch your set, there's more. Neighbors Nourishing Community built four large mobile germinating stations for the local students at Mitch Charter School, and they're gonna use that for education as well as raising plants for starts to hand out back to the neighbors' nursing communities for these people to grow their gardens. So they're going to be able to start up to 800 plants every 60 days and learn about nature and agriculture and biology. Again, Chad, Frank, you guys are the best. Woo! We talked about the A in STEM makes steam. Tualatin is lucky to have great partners in the arts. Masque and Mirror Community Theater, I mentioned Willowbrook. The Historical Society, Winona Grange, they bring in shows that reflect Tualatin's values, our community, our history. This past year, Masque and Mirrors held a summer musical, Singing in the Rain. The Historical Society brings in all kinds of historical presentations. Willowbrook is a gem in this community for decades. People come from all over the region for their kids to get immersed in culture and arts throughout the summer. These programs are important to not only, Mayor Truax was talking today in the mayor's meeting about how important STEM is, but STEM doesn't work without the arts, without STEAM, without the soft skills. So thank you for the arts people and all they do. Tualatin Police Department, we know you're the best. Under the leadership of Kent Barker, the department has cultivated a really strong relationship by their presence in community policing. They're the good guys in the community. They're the folks that people want to see in their neighborhoods. They're the friendly faces. And they build programs like National Night Out and Great, and very, very popular Citizens Police Academy coming up on its sixth year. And then Tualatin has our own fire department. Now we share that with a few other cities, but Tualatin Valley Fire and Rescue is our fire department. We're proud to have Station 34 right here in Tualatin. Chief Dyke is here, and the captain that makes Station 34 run and does a special hazmat training for the whole district. And they've partnered with Legacy Meridian Park to do training of CPR. So now every seventh and eighth grader in Hazelbrook Middle School has learned how to provide that life-saving skill. So I'd like our police and fire folks to stand up. And for all you do to protect us, to serve us, take care of us, thank you very much. You're the best. I don't know if Chief Barker's here. Chief Barker's here. All right. He's recognized across this state, across this nation, as a superlative servant in his profession. He served as the president of the Oregon Association of Chiefs of Police. He's received their prestigious Paul Nagy Award. He's a graduate of the Federal Bureau of Investigation National Academy, no easy task. He brought accreditation, which is a formal term, to our police department. He served on the board of directors and the executive committee for the International Association of Chiefs of Police. He's the chairman of the board of Oregon's Police Safety Standards and Training, and the list goes on and on. But for us, here in Tualatin, Chief Barker is the leader who's truly moved our police department to a level of greatness, punctuated by its prowess, by its honor, by its character. You know, I said it at the police banquet the other night, the speed of the train is determined by the speed of the engine. Our engine has been Ken Barker. In June of this year, Chief Barker, our Superman, will become plain old Mr. Kent. Chief, we owe you a tremendous thanks. You're the best, buddy. Did you know that Tualatin citizens enjoy the lowest municipal tax rate of any community in the region? Wilsonville's very close. Tualatin, but we get tremendous value for a fraction of the cost of some of the other city rates because our people, as Sherilyn said in the video, really care about providing service. They take this job seriously. I'm proud of our staff and the things that they do to maintain high levels because it's a reflection of them. When they see what they do, they see themselves. So I'd like our city staff to stand. They put this thing together, this program, the staging of it. I don't know who all is here from the Tualatin City staff, but if you raise your arm, I'd like to give you a cheer. You're the best. Tualatin City staff. The Tualatin City Council. Got six people in the council who put up with me. And they leave their families, and they leave their jobs, and they put in tremendous hours here in Tualatin at city council meetings all over the region, representing Tualatin in all kinds of forums. And it's not a mayor's job. It's a shared job. And our council does that in spades. I just want to recognize, I mentioned earlier, but Ed Truax, Monique Bikeman, Joel Davis, Nancy Grimes, Frank Bumnick, and Wade Brooksby. Some of you guys are here tonight. Again, just thanks for all you do year in and year out. So we spent 3 days together a year ago, January, and talked about our priorities for 2015 through 17. We've made a lot of progress in a lot of those goals, including transit, including local transit, including a marijuana policy, Basalt Creek, and the city facilities study. And just this past month in December, actually 2 months ago, Tualatin and Wilsonville, we worked together on that Basalt Creek plan that I talked about, which is deciding the boundary between the two cities, how it was going to be used, how it was going to be zoned. A very, very involved, difficult process. And again, thanks to the partnership between the two cities. And then in the coming year in Tualatin, we'll be doing our outreach to finish the concept planning so we can start issuing annexation and building permits. And once that's complete, we will be we'll become home to thousands of new jobs, hundreds of new residents. We'll be able to expand our southern neighborhood, and we'll have transition of green spaces into office facilities, and then finally into high-value manufacturing, like you're seeing in here tonight, as we have a smooth transition into Wilsonville. And so that is a big achievement of those two city councils. We worked hard on the city's facilities program. We narrowed it down to two locations for a new city hall. One is at the near the police building where we already own land. The other is on the commons at the side of the old Wichita pub. There's still a lot of work to be done, a lot of public involvement to be done on that, some more cost analysis, and determining at what level the city wants to fund that new facility. But we have a demand and a need for an expanded library, for centralized city hall, more meeting space, so we'll be working on that this year. We'll begin our 20-year update of our Parks Master Plan. People talk about Tualatin. I hear three things. We won't mention the first one, the T word. The other thing, traffic. The other thing that you talk about is the great businesses and the great parks. And so we're going to do a 20-year update of our Parks Master Plan and recreate for the future what has been done in the past. It's a place where our people get to rejuvenate themselves, where families and friends get to come together, ball fields, picnics, take walks, just enjoy being outside. Our parks play an important role to public health and public well-being. And we've addressed some important policy issues related to public health, such as removing soda pop from our vending machines, zoning marijuana dispensaries away from schools and neighborhoods. And we're currently working on standards to join the rest of our neighboring cities in making all of our city facilities tobacco-free. Beyond that, community health requires a culture of healthy eating, as well as active living, H-E-A-L, HEAL. Tualatin became one of Oregon's first HEAL cities, along with Wilsonville, by virtue of our parks and trails and our walk and bike to school days and workplaces. And the Chamber has developed Fit City Tualatin, providing free workouts in the summertime on the commons, workplace wellness and in wellness fairs along with the pool center. This year we'll be working on a blue zone project, which will move us even further toward the goals. The council's going, what is it? I haven't heard about that yet. Well, we'll talk about that. It's a private effort that is going to involve the city and everyone else in terms of reducing childhood obesity, improving healthy workforce, and providing healthy food options. I want to thank Allison Anderson from Reading Park, Ernie Brown from Tualatin Tiger School District, our superintendent, Dr. Jeff Clark from True Health Medicine, Robert Knight, the Chamber President, Express Employment Professionals, Megan Barnett of Providence, for comprising that initial beginning working group on how we proceed on that great endeavor. So stay tuned for Blue Zones. Okay, I'm proud of this community. I'm so grateful to our partners who helped Tualatin flourish. The spirit of collaboration and partnership in this city is what sets us apart, but makes us whole with everyone else, and makes us, in my opinion, the best. So could everybody please stand? Everybody please stand. Every one of you contribute to this community. Thank you for making Tualatin the best city south of the North Pole. Let's hear it. Tualatin, you're the best, all of you. Thank you for what you do. Good night, and God bless. Enjoy the rest of the evening.